Beside Westminster Bridge in the heart of London, just across the street from the Houses of Parliament, is the statue of Boudica, Queen of the Iceni, driving her chariot, her daughters behind her. The Iceni were one of many Celtic tribes that occupied Britain 2,000 years ago. We might compare them with the Native American tribes in our country. Around 43 AD, the Roman Empire sent troops to conquer Britain. Boudica's husband, the king of the Iceni, got along with the Roman invaders, but when he died, the Romans attacked, flogging Boudica and raping her daughters. She rallied the Celtic forces and rebelled against the Romans. This woman and her primitive tribes for a while defeated the mighty Roman legions. Eventually, however, her troops were badly outnumbered and defeated. During the Roman occupation of Britain, the Celtic tribes were pressed back into the corners of the British Isles, into what are now Wales and Scotland. Their language, or its descendants, became the Gaelic languages of Scotland and Wales. Little remains of the Celtic language in modern English. So how did all of this affect the development of the English language? There's little direct influence, but it cleared the way for the next set of invaders, who did bring the English language. In the 5th century, 400 years after they arrived in Britain, the Roman troops were needed at home and were recalled. With the Roman legions gone, those left behind were unable to defend themselves, and the rich Roman settlements were left nearly defenseless against a new set of invaders, the Anglo-Saxons.